Hey guys, welcome back to electronicsinnovation.com. In this video, we are going to see how to visualize AWS IoT Core data on Ubidots platform. Till now, I have connected ESP32, ESP8266 and Raspberry Pi to the AWS IoT Core and saved data into the DynamoDB using different methods. I always wanted to visualize the data that is being sent to the AWS IoT Core. Till yesterday, I did not find any easy and efficient way to do that. But today I have found a way to visualize the AWS data with an eye-catching user interface. So without wasting time, let's get started.
If you wanted to convert your prototype projects into the real-time applications and deploy in the real-time field, you need to design a PCB because devices with these wearables will not last long. PCB way is the one of the best way to convert your prototypes into the real-time applications. I have used their services to convert my prototypes into the real-time applications. PCB way is the one of the best PCB manufacturers in the current industry. At PCBWay.com, we can get 10 pieces of 2-layer PCBs at just $5 with 24 hours build time. And also PCB way offering PCB assembling services at just $30 with free shipping. I have provided the link in the description. Do check out their website for more details. This video is continuation of the previous part. If you did not watch that video, please go and watch that video using the above link and then come back to here. Let's move to the fourth part, programming part. Here is the code that we have developed in the previous video. We have used this code to post Mac ID, temperature and humidity to the topic called EIOut. I am going to use the same code with small modifications according to the Ubidots requirements. The only thing I have changed is the MQTT topic and structure of the JSON message. I added this line to copy the MQTT topic, which is ubidots/v1/MAC address of the ESP32 modules. I am using the MAC address of the ESP32 as device label. Why? Because it is the unique address you can get for every ESP32 module. If we use large number of devices, we can easily identify the particular device with the MAC ID. Then I have edited the structure of the JSON message. This time, I am sending temperature and humidity only. Then printing both MQTT topic and JSON message on serial monitor for debugging purpose. Finally publishing the JSON message to the MQTT topic. I have declared these two variables as we are using to store MQTT topic. That's it. The rest of the code doesn't have any changes. I have already uploaded AWS certificates using the ESP32 sketch data upload tool. So I'm not gonna do that again. Connect ESP32 with PC and check uploading configurations like ESP32 rover module, uploading speed, and partition scheme should be default 4MB with SPIFS because we are using the SPIFS file system of ESP32. Then select the right port. If everything is okay, upload code. Till then the code gets uploaded, I wanted to let you know one thing about our channel. As you can see here, 95% of people who are watching videos in our channel are not subscribed. If you are new to this channel or you didn't subscribe yet, I request you to subscribe and opt to notifications if and only if you find this video is something informative and useful to you. While Arduino log showing like this, press and hold the boot button until it turns as writing at some address. Then release it. After successful uploading, open serial monitor. Now it's time for the final part, testing and demonstration of data logging and data visualization on AWS and Ubidots respectively. On the serial monitor, we can see our ESP32 successfully connected to the programmed Wi-Fi and allocated with the IP address. Then it reads the AWS certificates from the SPIFS and printed over here. Then it read the MAC ID of ESP32 and printed over here. Then initiated the MQTT connection with AWS Cloud and connected to it. Now it started publishing JSON data to the MQTT topic ub.v1/MAC address. We can also see the temperature and humidity data on the OLED display. Copy this MQTT topic, come back to AWS IoT Core, click on the test option at the left panel and subscribe to the copied topic ub.v1/MAC address. We can see the data being published to the AWS here. And this data is in the Ubidots required format. Now go to the Ubidots and reload it to see the updated devices. Here we can see Ubidots is automatically created a device with MAC ID for us. Click on the device. We can also see that Ubidots automatically created variables and started storing the received data. Click on the variable to see the previous data points. To visualize these data points, click on Data and then choose Dashboard. Click on Add New Widget. You will be prompted with bunch of data visualization options. Choose one among them. I will use Thermometer because it will good to visualize the temperature and humidity. Click on Add Variables, then select the device and select the variable temperature. Keep the rest of the settings default and create it. We can see the temperature on the newly created widget. Repeat the same process for humidity. Change the color of the widget to differentiate temperature and humidity. Add another widget, line chart, to plot graph using temperature data. Repeat the same process for humidity. That's it. Now we have an eye-catching user interface to visualize the AWS data. And we are able to receive the data points seamlessly without any error. Now I will try to increase the temperature at the sensor with gas lighter. You can see the increment in the temperature and decrement in the humidity, because temperature and humidity are the inversely proportional to each other. We can see the same data on four different mediums like Ubidots, AWS, serial monitor and OLED display, because all are synchronized with each other. Once the testing is done, close all the connections before you leave, otherwise you will end up charged by the AWS. Let's see the billing structure of AWS Kinesis. Search for billing in the Amazon Services search bar. Click on the billing option. This will take you to the billing and cost management dashboard. Here, we can see the last month, month to date and month end forecasted cost. I have been using this AWS Kinesis from past 2 days for my testing and demonstration purpose. I have been charged 80 Indian rupees, which is around $1.06. If I continue to use the service till the end of this August month, I may charge more, $1.34, as it forecasted. This cost is only for Kinesis. I am also using AWS IoT Core, DynamoDB and CloudWatch for other projects. But I did not get charged for that because I am using AWS free tier account. At the beginning of the video, I promised to tell you how you can test this feature with Ubidots for educational purpose with less than $1. So you can test this feature with Ubidots and AWS for 1 or 2 days, as I have done right now. Once your testing is done, you can either delete or disable the resources from AWS. Visit AWS Kinesis, delete Ubidots data stream. Visit AWS IoT Core, delete Ubidots AWS IoT rule. Visit IAM Management Console, delete Ubidots user which I have created earlier. Visit Ubidots platform and delete the AWS IoT plugin. Delete the device and also delete the data visualization widgets. So, by deleting all these resources, you will not be charged further. But this is only for educational purpose. If you wanted to use this feature, you have to pay for the resources you are using. Forwarding your data through Kinesis is more effective than other approaches such as AWS Lambda.
So, that's it for this tutorial. This is how we can post temperature and humidity data to the AWS IoT Core and visualize the same data on Ubidots platform. Now you have everything to deploy real-time IoT device. I hope this video will help you to develop end-to-end IoT devices. In the future videos, I will try to concentrate more on hardware part and provide you the complete guidance on PCB designing, manufacturing and assembling process. See you soon on the next interesting project. Bye-bye.